All right. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Mercy Morning Tea. It's our Christmas extravaganza. Look, you can see we got little hats.
It's hard to see them.
It's right there.
But they're there, I promise.
That's right.
I'm a little too tall for this today, but we'll make do.
I know. We need to make ourselves littler. Anyway, I'm Julie Mercer-Kidd. Look, ho, 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 Santa Claus. And you
are? I'm Brad Haller. I'm the social media specialist at Mercy. Coming on for a special Christmas event.
I know, and that's because Brad is so good at putting my Christmas slides together. You're awesome.
Yeah.
So if you all ever need help to put your PowerPoint presentations to look really awesome, hook up with Brad right here. Yeah, because he's like, don't say that. Well, we have a fun show for you today.
We do.
Right? Because
yes.
It's like Christmas
right.
And
yeah,
Advent. So can you move the... closer to the slide
thing. Still, I want to keep looking at it, though. These are pretty funny.
I know. Those are like our Snapchat pictures.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, they're Christmas filters everywhere.
I know. Well, so, you know, Brad, we're in the season of Advent.
Correct.
Right? So we are a faith-based.
Second week.
We are, actually. We are a faith-based ministry. We're a part of Catholic Healthcare. And in our faith tradition in Mercy, we are our church season of Advent. So Advent is the four Sundays leading up to Christmas.
Right.
And so there's really kind of an energy of preparation for the coming Christ child. So what do we do, you know, to prepare for that? And I found a story about Advent, and at the end of the story it said, Advent is the extraordinary moment just before something extraordinary happens. So it is as if that moment, for those of you watching who have had children, who have birthed a baby, it's that moment, like, right, the baby's about to come out, and you're so excited, you could hardly wait. Like, when I gave birth to my son, I didn't know if it was a boy or a girl. So that anticipation, right, leading up to it, like, I had one more push, and the baby's going to come out, and I know the doctor's going to say, so it's that hype of excitement, right? Something extraordinary.
Mm-hmm.
It's that feeling that we are to keep anticipation all through the season of Advent. So if you can, you know, imagine that.
Yeah.
Or
that's
you
a good
know
analogy,
yeah, or another exciting analogy is, you know, there's some exciting guests coming to your house, like you've been told. You're gonna have a surprise guest coming to your house.
Right.
Yeah, maybe.
Cool.
And the doorbell rings. And you're excited, right? So it's that moment you're about to open the door because you don't know who's behind that door, but you know it's going to be an exciting surprise. And you, it's that hype of anticipation.
Yeah, like getting a package from Amazon. What
yeah,
is it?
I
didn't
know.
Order anything.
I know, and you're going to open it.
It's a glitter bomb.
Yeah. I'm totally getting you.
No idea. No, don't send me anything.
That's right. But anyway, it's that feeling that is the Advent season.
Very cool.
Right? So I like that extraordinary moment just before something extraordinary happens. So we are in that season. And in the church and at Mercy, there are ways that we prepare, right?
Right.
So here are some really great pictures that we found. Probably you took some of them. I don't know.
A few. Well, yeah.
Yeah.
The top left there, that's the second week. Yeah, we just posted that one on Mercy's social media platform on Sunday to mark the second week of Advent. And that was actually taken in the chapel at Mercy St. Louis.
Right. So see, look, it's right there.
Yeah.
And we see that, so you've got the sisters with Santa.
Santa is on their nice list.
That's right. So that's kind of how people, you know, prepare, having fun events. They collect food. They collect bags of goodies.
That was actually, one of our doctors brought in a bunch of goodies for Mercy Kids. And that's all the bags. And now the doctor's name escapes me. Gosh darn it. But they were really excited about getting all this in for Mercy Kids. At the Family Resource Center and, of course, the clinic over there. Everybody's going to be using them. And then there's the boxes of pretty awesome donations. So
I love it. So there's different ways that we prepare and include folks for Advent. So next slide, please.
Let's do it.
Yeah. So there are ways that we prepare, right, for Advent in our own homes. So a lot of folks decorate Christmas trees. I love it when people bake cookies. I was in your break room, so this is the marketing building I'm in.
Yep.
You all have, like, pumpkin bread and cookies. I mean, people have brought all kinds of things. So there's ways that, you know, we bring Christmas cheer and sugar.
Calories.
To everyone. We've a lot of Christmas caroling happens to bring Christmas cheer to folks.
Have you done that yet?
I haven't yet this
season. Because you're on the choir.
I know, but
I'm
we actually
know.
We sang at the patient access Christmas party here in Springfield the
oh, cool.
other night. Yeah.
Well, there you go.
And we're singing tonight at the hospital memorial service.
Oh yeah.
So our little choir. So
excellent.
Yeah.
What time
so
is that?
That is at 7 o'clock.
7 p.m.
Yeah.
Okay.
7 p.m. So maybe something you all could do is get your department and just go sing to another department,
easy.
Right?
Super
yeah.
easy.
Good thing.
So the lyrics are on Google. So.
Exactly. And Christmas traditions. So everyone has different Christmas traditions that they do to prepare their homes and their hearts to get ready for this Christmas season. We want to be mindful, though, Hanukkah started a couple of days ago, so there are other faith traditions that happen within this season as well. So Hanukkah and then Kwanzaa starts really after
after Christmas,
after
right?
Christmas.
Yeah, the 26th,
yep.
I believe.
Yeah, so lots of time of preparation. So that's kind of our theme today is how do we prepare our hearts and our minds to receive the Christ child in this faith-based ministry. But I also want to think about Brad, how do we prepare ourselves for work every day, right? Because we know that we work in healthcare and it is not easy work.
Right.
It's very demanding. It demands a lot of us emotionally, mentally, physically sometimes. So I think about Catherine and the stories of the sisters, ways that they prepare themselves through prayer. So I think a lot of folks might serve in facilities where they might hear an overhead prayer, so being able to actually pause in that moment and remember, you know, why we're serving and who we serve that day. Other ways, I just had a picture of, you know, kind of the blessing of hands, being able to think about, you know, how our hands will be healing folks and providing that healing presence for people. But I also think about we have to prepare ourselves really mentally, emotionally, physically. We've got to take good care of ourselves, too.
Of course, yeah.
So during this season, especially with all the calories and sugar,
yes.
It's probably good to maybe find some time to exercise.
Right.
Yeah, take good care of ourselves.
Walk as much as possible.
Yes.
Past the cookies.
Yes, exactly.
That's what I do every day, and it's very difficult.
I walk right to the cookies.
I see them. Right.
That's right to them. I step.
Hey, but you're moving. That's
right. Right, exactly. Mm-hmm. Then I step in place and eat.
Yeah.
But we have to be thinking of how do we prepare ourselves, really, and even our attitudes. To approach work every day here, because our attitude, if we don't have a good attitude, we're probably not going to have a good day. We're probably not going to be good to people, our coworkers, ourselves, our patients. So we always have to be thinking of that sense of preparation. So remember earlier in the show, I was talking about that extraordinary moment before an extraordinary happening, that sense of anticipation. We should come to work every day with kind of that feeling, and we call that fullness for life. It's one of our charism, that fullness for life that really pushes us forward to serve faithfully in what we do. So we have we can't show this video, really.
Yeah, you know how WebEx is.
Yeah, so it's hard to show this video live, but we're going to post it on our Facebook page. But you can YouTube or Google it, and it's you see Forest Hill Church, Charlotte, North Carolina, made this really fun video of really what it is to be thankful for the gifts around us as we prepare ourselves this Advent season and for Christmas. And the whole preface is the gentleman is wrapped in Christmas paper and he pops up and says, I'm alive. I mean,
that's a gift.
I know, right?
That's
be
awesome.
Thankful that we're alive. The kids come in wrapped in Christmas presents. They're
awesome.
Like, kind of what's happening, you know, that they're a gift to the world. And all through, it's just about a minute long, everything he touches, water, the fact that we have running water, clean running water to bathe ourselves, to brush our teeth, to drink. Gosh, want to be thankful for that. Then he's eating breakfast and drinking coffee and then runs out to his car. You see that at the top. And really the last scene is to really be thankful for all the gifts around you. So as we prepare ourselves for Christmas, but also preparing every day, the work that we do here at Mercy, we want to be able to be thankful for all the gifts that we have and the people that we get to serve for. So, Brad, I'm thankful for you.
Well, likewise.
I've been saying thank you to him 10,000 times in the last 15 minutes for putting together this great slideshow with the snowflakes.
It's so fun, though.
So exciting. So here's the reflection. So reflect on this with your coworkers, with those around you. How do we prepare ourselves for living out the healing ministry of Jesus every day, right? How do we do that every single day? And if we did an Advent attitude check today, how are we doing for the ministry? Advent attitude, right?
I know.
I kind of made that up. Advent attitude. How are we doing for the ministry? So, Brad, how are you doing for the ministry today?
Great.
Yeah, me too. I mean, having fun and festive.
I think that's a good reminder, though, to on the way into work, you know, just to reassess a little bit, get some perspective. And that video really has me thinking a lot about the things around me that I'm blessed to have and be able to get and provide to others.
Yeah, well, because that affects our attitude, right?
Totally.
So many times we think of things that we don't have. And that affects the way we even prepare our hearts and our minds for the coming Christ child, for the coming season, and even for the work that we do. So, hey, everyone, have a very Merry Christmas, a Happy New Year. We're hoping we're going to take probably several weeks off. We're going to try to make this an even more fun show after the New Year, so stay tuned. And have a very Merry Christmas, Brad. Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you, too, everybody watching.
Yeah, and as Catherine said, resolve to be good today.
And even better tomorrow.
And jingle bells. All right.
Merry Christmas.